England won the World Cup. What an amazing World Cup campaign. Hopefully I can say that in a month's time, talking about the FIFA World Cup. But I can say that now because England won the T20 Cricket World Cup that took place across Australia. And it was a really successful tournament overall. Not just the fact because I'm English and saw England win the World Cup, but there were just so many entertaining games, twists and turns everywhere. So it was a fantastic, successful tournament. Let's start all the way at the beginning at the qualifying rounds where the West Indies finished bottom of their qualifying group. So the 2016 champions that beat England in India didn't even qualify for the main draw. Then we had Australia playing against their somewhat local rivals New Zealand, and they lost by 89 runs, and that will prove crucial for New Zealand's progress to the semi-finals and also Australia's downfall for being knocked out in the group stages. From one major rivalry to another, India played Pakistan in a thrilling game, and in the final three overs, Pakistan conceded 50 runs, which meant that India just edged ahead of Pakistan and won that game. There was also so many shocks. You had Ireland beating England, Zimbabwe beating Pakistan by a single run, and then you had South Africa beating India. But then it was in South Africa's hands to progress to the semi-finals, and they lost against already knocked out Netherlands, which meant South Africa were knocked out and India progressed. And you had hosts Australia almost losing to Afghanistan, which would have been absolutely crazy scenes. But Australia just about won by 4 runs, but it still wasn't enough for them to progress to the semi-finals. Australia can feel somewhat hard done by the fact they were knocked out and they only lost one game, but their loss against New Zealand was really bad. So the first semi-final was New Zealand against Pakistan, and in the end, it was Pakistan's incredible bowling that got them through. For New Zealand, they have so much talent, but in the crucial moments, it just doesn't seem to be working out for them in white ball cricket. Then on to India versus England in the semi-final, and India had a relatively good score. You know, Pandev and Kohli were really, really good, but my God, England's batting. Butler and Hales just decided to show up in the semi-final. The only match in the whole World Cup where one team won by 10 wickets. Incredible stuff from Butler and Hales. Just completely destroyed India and any real contest. Phenomenal from England. And then on to the final between England and Pakistan. And I was really worried going into this game that it would be completely rained off. Thankfully, there was no rain whatsoever. And thankfully, England won the toss, which meant that they batted second and Pakistan had to bat first. And England's bowling was fantastic. You know, Adil Rashid, Curran eventually named not only the player of the match but player of the tournament, which you can't really argue against, because Curran not only took the second most wickets in the whole tournament, crucially he kept that run rate down, and the fact that England managed to get Mohammad Rizwan out really early was just absolutely massive. And then when England came to bat, I was kind of optimistic and hopeful, but then you see Hales be completely bowled, Butler get an okay score, but then Phil Salt goes out early, and then in the power play, England eventually lose 3 wickets, and that's quite worrying. But if there's one man to step up in the big occasion in cricket for England, it's Ben Stokes. Time and time again in crucial matches, Ben Stokes stands up and just thrives off the occasion. This was his first half century in T20 cricket. What a time to get it. Afridi's injury was crucial to England winning. Once Afridi got injured, England, and crucially Stokes and Moeen Ali, just decided to attack the Pakistan bowlers, and it worked. And in the end, it was relatively comfortable after that. The only downside of the tournament was that some of the matches were rained off or hampered because of the rain. And I'm really thinking here, Australia versus England. I would have loved to have watched that match as an England fan in Australia, but that match was completely abandoned because of the rain. I must admit though, I think Australia would have probably been the favourites going into that game, and they probably would have won. So it's kind of a relief in a way that that match was abandoned, but no, I'd love to have seen that game, and it is a shame that some of the matches were either abandoned or hampered because of the rain. But overall, what a fantastic advert for cricket. What a brilliant tournament. So that's one World Cup success for England. Can they make it 2 in a month's time when England play in the Qatar FIFA World Cup? Let me know your thoughts about the T20 Cricket World Cup in the comments below, and where this England side can go, and let me know who you support. I'd really, really love to see those comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you found this video valuable and entertaining, and be sure to check out the next video. Thank you very much.